All right, so it's time to paint the rest of the bike. We are not going to be painting the side panels. Chris voted them off. He said that they looked a little bit too boxy. So I'm going to put that battery back up where I originally had it, under the seat there, or behind the seat rather. And we're just going to paint these three parts. We have the tank, the front fender, and this rear cowl. So I'm gonna start. I'm gonna pull them off. I'm gonna drain the tank. I'm gonna take the cap and the petcock off of the tank, sand it down just a little bit, and cover it with some primer. Additionally, we've got some really cool stencils that I'm gonna be experimenting with. We've got this, some numbers there, and then we've got the Cobra stencils. These ones. We got a whole bunch in case I mess it up. And hopefully some left over for Chris's car. See, now this is why we don't use RTV to seal petcock gaskets or carburetor bowl gaskets. Chris's tank was all full of this stuff, just floating around waiting to clog shit up. Guess Chris's bike had tapeworms. Right, so everything's all dried out. Now I'm going to take some medium grit sandpaper and just sort of get everything as smooth as possible. For this stage, I generally use about 400 grit sandpaper, and once we prime it, then I go up to the finer stuff. Look at this. This has been a crazy day. Black Widow on Chris's bike. See, there's the hourglass. Oh. Yeah. Oops. Let's see. Poor thing. She's all covered in this paint dust. Did you guys see the hourglass? See it? I'm gonna take her outside and put her in a bush. Alright, so that's about as smooth as it's gonna get. So now we're gonna dump a bunch of primer on there and let it dry. Looking not too shabby. Now let's give that a day to dry and we can sand it down and start putting on some color. Alright, so it's the next day. This primer is dry. Everything's looking really positive. This is a good quality primer I'm using, and so it's a nice solid coat. I'm going to sand it down, sand it real smooth. And then assess whether or not I'm going to put another layer of primer on it. And if not, then I'm going to lay the base coat of the color today. I know this color doesn't really come across very well on camera. When I watched the last video about the wheels, it sort of reminded me of like an old Jewish lady's fingernails, you know? But in person, this really is just a spectacular coat of paint. It just looks great. This I know I'm definitely a novice at painting still, but this is my brand beer that I bought from an auto paint shop that was closing down, and it's just the best paint that I've ever used. And I've only used a couple paints, you know, but it's such a pleasure to work with. Goes on smooth, dries right away. I mean, it's very forgiving paint for me anyway. And it just looks spectacular. I know the Cafe Racer was the same brand of paint, and it ended up really nice. But this is gonna look really cool. So I threw down some red. We're gonna let this dry, and then we'll put the stencils on and the racing stripes, and put on some black. So unfortunately, this is totally my fault. The numbers are obviously way too big, the serial numbers. I think I may have accidentally been ordering in inches when I thought I was ordering in centimeters. So we're gonna forego the numbers, just do a racing stripe on each fender, and a racing stripe on the tank, and we've got a couple of stencils I'm gonna put on. Just like I did on the cafe racer, you can use tape to be a spacer. Now this part of the project I'm actually a little bit nervous about, because these aren't made to be painting stencils. These are just like stickers that go on your car window. And so I don't know if they're gonna leave any kind of residue behind, or how they're gonna hold up to the reducer in the paint. Because the reducer can't bubble the vinyl of the sticker while the paint is still wet, obviously, or else it'll destroy the image. That, and then I have to pick off all these little itty bitty little parts here with, you know, an X-Acto knife or with my fingernail or whatever to peel it out of the paint. So we do have just enough red left that if I had to, I could just scrap the whole thing, paint the tank red again, and then just do some racing stripes. So hopefully it doesn't come down to that. There you go. There's our stencil. A nice glossy black, and now we wait a day. And I can peel those things off and see how they turned out. So the front fender and the cowl turned out really nice. Really gorgeous. Now it's time to unsheath the tank. Now on the other side, we're having some pretty significant issues with sticker residue. And on this side, there's almost nothing. You can see there's just a little bit here for me to clean up. And that is because I chose to try and heat this side up with a hairdryer. So that'll definitely be something that I remember in the future. I think it turned out pretty good. Now we are all crisp and shiny with a couple of layers of clear coat. Once that dries, the painting is going to be finally finished.